Hello viewers, welcome back to Farmdipedia. We are back again with another video. Our topic is envenomations, arthropod bites and stings. So, as we are discussing about envenomation, we need to know what is envenomation. It is a process by which venom is introduced in the body through the bite or a sting of a venomous animal. Phylum Arthropoda comprises of four classes. Class Arachnida has two orders. They are Scorpionida and Araneida. Scorpionida comprises of scorpions, example black scorpion, red scorpion. Order Araneida comprises of spiders, example black widow, brown recluse. Class Insecta has three orders. Order Hymenoptera comprises bees, wasps and ants. Order Lepidoptera includes butterflies and moths. Order Coleoptera includes beetles. Then class Chilopoda includes centipedes. Class Diplopoda includes millipedes. Venomous arachnids. It includes scorpions and spiders. Scorpions examples black scorpion or Palamnius gravimanus, red scorpion or Mesobutus tamulus. Among all the scorpion families, the family Butidae possess the most potent venom. The toxins present are phospholipase, acetylcholine esterase, serotonin, hyaluronidase and neurotoxins. Butus species venom has phospholipase A, which is responsible for gastrointestinal and pulmonary hemorrhage and disseminated intravascular coagulation. Mechanism of action. This venom affects sodium channels of adrenergic and parasympathetic neurons, thereby leads to prolongation of action potentials leading to depolarization of these neurons. Clinical features. They may be local or systemic. Local features include pain, swelling, redness, and regional lymphadenopathy. Systemic features are midriasis, excess salivation, urticaria, hypertension, bradyotachyarrhythmiasis, profuse sweating, vomiting, priapism, pulmonary edema, hyperglycemia, intracerebral hemorrhage, which leads to hemiparesis, convulsions. Especially for Palamnia species, local pain, paresthesia, salivation, nausea, sweating, mild hypotension, and eosinophilia. Treatment. Local application of ice and supportive measures for pain relief can be helpful for victims without cardiac disease, hypertension, and children greater than 5 years of age. For victims with hypertension and cardiac problems and children less than 5 years old, an immediate hospital administration may be required. So during transport to hospital, we need to immobilize the affected area and do not apply tourniquet. Local application of ice may release the pain. If available, negative pressure suction device can be used to extract the venom. On arrival at hospital, the patient with systemic manifestation can be treated by shifting immediately to ICU and by monitoring ECG, echocardiography and hemodynamics. And in case of respiratory failure or CNS disturbances, mechanical ventilation and oxygen administration may be required. Symptomatic treatment is helpful, such as for pain, paracetamol or morphine can be given. For mild to moderate allergies, antihistamines with or without beta agonist, glucocorticoids or adrenaline can be given. For agitations and convulsions, diazepam 5 to 10 mg IV can be administered. For vomitings, metoclopramide 5 to 10 mg IV can be given. Scorpion venom antagonist, prazosin hydrochloride which is 500 micrograms, can be administered every 4 to 6 hours in adults, and 250 mg administered every 4 to 6 hours in children. Antivenom therapy can be recommended in these cases. Goat serum derived antivenoms have a risk of serum sickness syndrome. So, scorpion antivenom can be used. One vial initially, then administered for venomous spiders. Examples: black widow spider or Latrodectus mactans. Brown recluse spiders or Loxosceles reclusa. Venom. Spider venom is neurotoxic. It has 6 active components. The main active component in spider venom is alpha-latrotoxin. This toxin binds to presynaptic receptors such as gangliocytes and glycoproteins at synapses. It affects motor end plates of synaptic membranes. Therefore, sodium channels remain open and sodium influx occurs. Due to this, extensive release of noradrenaline and acetylcholine into synapses occurs and inhibits reuptake. Therefore, massive stimulation of motor end plates is seen. Clinical features. They may be divided into 3 grades. They are grade 1, grade 2 and grade 3. Grade 1 clinical features include sharp pain with 1 or 2 small punctured wounds of size 1 to 2 mm. Warm, mildly indurated, slightly redness and swelling can be seen with no systemic features. In grade 2 features, muscular pain, pain extending to trunk, local diaphoresis, tender regional lymphadenopathy with no systemic features are observed. In grade 3 features, generalized muscle pains, weakness with difficulty in walking, and systemic clinical features are observed. Sweating, tachycardia, hypertension are commonly seen. On ECG finding, prolonged QT interval, slurring of QRS with ST and T segments are observed. Common clinical features include nausea, vomiting, headache, and leukocytosis. In severe cases, tosses, salivation, tremors, convulsions, and tachypnea respiratory compromise can be seen. Diagnosis: leukocytosis, elevated creatinine kinase levels, and albuminuria can be observed in these victims. Treatment. For pain relief, combination of IV morphine or pethidine and benzodiazepines like diazepam or lorazepam may be given. To treat mild pain, aspirin, paracetamol or codeine may be required. Application of cold or warm compress may also be useful. To relieve swelling or inflammation, NSAIDs are given. To relieve muscle spasms, muscle relaxants like diazepam, methocarbamol or dantrolene can be used. Tetanus prophylaxis may be recommended. In case of wounds, clean the wound by using antiseptics. Immobilization, elevation, serial observation are mandatory. Antibiotics are administered if required. If lesion exceeds 4 cm at 12 hours post-envenomation, then surgical intervention may be necessary. Class Chylopoda. It includes centipedes. Class Chylopoda has 4 orders. They are Scutigeromorpha, Lithibiomorpha, Geophyllomorpha and Scolopendromorpha. Among this, Scolopendromorpha are most venomous. Centipedes are 50 segmented creatures with 100 legs. They have long, dorsoventrally flattened bodies with 15 to 18 somites. They possess neurotoxic venom, and their bites appear to be pointed. Symptoms: painful bites characterized by immediate local burning pain, erythema, swelling, inflammation, lymphadenopathy, superficial necrosis, and lymphangitis, of which edema lasts for several hours, and local pain, wound may bleed. Systemic features includes anxiety, dizziness, vomiting, headache, cardiac arrhythmias, convulsions. Especially for Scolopendra species, rhabdomyolysis and renal failure may be observed. Treatment. Supportive care may be needed. The treatment is same as scorpion sting. Local application of ice may be helpful. For severe pain, local anesthetic may be given. Topical corticosteroids along with antihistamines and local anesthetics may be helpful. Tetanus prophylaxis is recommended. Class Diplopoda. It comprises of millipedes. These are thousand-legged creatures. They do not bite and are not venomous but have glandular system. They produce a foul smell, disagreeable fluids which contains phenols and hydrocyanic acid. On exposure to these fluids, brown or purplish skin lesions along with blisters after a few days are observed. The skin may get peeled off and it takes a long time to heal. On contact with the eye, severe conjunctivitis, corneal ulceration, and blindness may occur. Treatment: immediate copious irrigation and application of topical antimicrobial agent is required. On eye injury, ophthalmic evaluation and treatment can be done. Venomous insects. There are three orders which are of toxicological importance. They are Hymenoptera, Coleoptera and Lepidoptera. Hymenoptera includes fire ants, honeybees, wasps, ants and hornets. Stings. Bees possess barbed stings whereas wasps possess smooth stings. Venom. Hymenoptera venom has three constituents: biogenic amines like histamines, serotonin and acetylcholine. Enzymes such as phospholipase A and hyaluronidase. Toxic peptides like kinins in wasps, apamin, melitin, mast cell degranulatic peptide in bees. Clinical features. It is divided into three reactions. They are local reactions, allergic reactions, and toxic reactions. Local reactions. Mild effects of bee sting includes local pain, redness, itching, and swelling. These may resolve in few hours. Local reactions are dangerous if sting is in vital location, example, mouth or tongue. It may lead to airway obstruction. In case of eyes, lacrimation, hyperemia, pain, swelling, and ulceration may be seen. Yellow jackets and wasp causes severe cutaneous infection and cellulitis. Allergic reactions. They may be divided into two types. They are anaphylaxis and delayed reactions. Anaphylaxis. It is a IgE-mediated type 1 hypersensitivity reaction. The clinical features include flushing, dizziness, visual disturbances, syncope, abdominal cramps, and tachycardia. In severe cases, urticaria, angioedema, profound hypotension, and coma. In case of multiple stings from honeybee may lead to cardiopulmonary arrest. Delayed reactions. It occurs after 1 to 5 days of a venomous sting. Few patients show urticaria, skin rashes, pedal edema and erythritis. Sometimes serum sickness syndrome may also occur. Toxic reactions. Multiple stings on massive envenomation may cause vasodilation, hypotension, fatigue, seizures, coma, edema and acute renal failure. Delayed toxic reactions are subsequent evidences of hemolysis, coagulopathy, thrombocytopenia, rhabdomyolysis and liver dysfunction. Treatment. For multiple sting affected patients, observe for at least 6 hours with lab evaluation for abnormalities like hemolysis, thrombocytopenia, liver and renal function, elevated creatinine and kinase and rhabdomyolysis. For local reaction, remove embedded stinger by scraping with blade or fingernail. Adrenaline 1:1000 dilution can be given. It impedes systemic venom absorption. Apply local cold compresses for every 30 minutes. Administer antibiotics if there is an evidence of infection. Treatment for allergic reaction. For anaphylaxis, 0.1% of adrenaline given subcutaneous or intramuscularly to relieve bronchospasm. For delayed reactions, antihistamines and analgesics are given. In case of renal failure patients, hemodialysis is suggested.